Okay, so now you make sure you got the bottom of the Mylar sheet here, and you put it into the top part of the holder here, and then you're going to bring it down and get it behind the ruler here, and you want to line up the holes with this feeder here. Actually, it's got to go behind the metal thing on the side here. Then you're going to take the wheel on the side. Well, this is for this one. The wheel may be on the other side there. Anyways, you've got some kind of wheel that brings this down. And I'm going to go right to the first row here. Now, I lucked out and I did get it to line up pretty good. If not, there's a little button here you could take to push that down. But see, I push it down, now it's off. You pretty much want to get it lined up with the blue line there. Now, this ruler here is made for the standard gauge machine. So if you have a bulky, you have to remember to divide these numbers in half. So instead of 63, actually, I'm going to have to round that off because you can't do odds on this. I'm going to have to do 64 or 62. I'm going to go 64 because I don't want to make this too small. I would rather have this a little bit larger because it will fit the person better that you're making it for. So now I look at it and I do have to cast on 34 left, 34 right. Okay, so you're going to cast on your favorite way. My favorite way is to do the latch tool or crochet cast on. And then thread it through your carriage. And I have my counters at zero. I do need to put both of my trippers down because I need the tripper on the right for this machine, the KH260 or the bulky, to do the row counter, and then the short one on the left is going to do this one. Now that's why you set up your machine or the knit leader on the left here, how to do these different things. So that, well, the top and the bottom, so that it will come out to what you need it to. Now, you can go and push all the material to the back there if you want, or it should do it automatically. So now I knit across. And then I'm going to hang my cast-on comb. Now, if you're lucky enough to have an LK100 or another bulky machine, you could probably use this cast-on comb a lot better. Because that is also a 9mm machine. It is weighted. I don't particularly like the cast-on comb that came with this machine, but that's all they had back then. Okay, so now as I go up, I have a mark here. That's the end of my ribbon. If I had my ribber on, I would stop there and then move all the stitches from the ribber to the knitter and then continue. But where I don't, and I'm gonna have to reform the ribbon by hand. I just keep going until I see that mark is right above the ruler. Went one past it. So now what I need to do is figure out if I could get a 2x2, well, that's the wrong one, rib, so that I could keep, and I can't do it that way, but I can go keep the single, the stitch on the edge by itself, and that is the same there also. So I'm going to bring these forward. Then I'm going to remove my claw weights and my cast-on comb. Then I'm just going to start reforming the stitches. So I take the first needle back, and then I just kind of use my fingers to bring it down. When I get down so far, I want to get my latch tool in that first stitch above the cast on. Then I can finish bringing down the rest of that. And then I take each ladder and draw it through the loop on the latch tool. Now what I should have done was, if I was going to do a 1x1 rib, I would have subtracted one cast-on stitch, and then I could have done it that way. If the 2x2 didn't work out, I would have checked something else. Now you can go 2x1, so it all depends, but you want to have at least the end needles on both sides where you do not have to reform them. You could try it. It's a little bit more, and for each loop there's actually one yarn, and you have to put it through twice. That's why I don't do that anymore. So you just continue down the line reforming your stitches, or if you had your ribber on, transferring using your double-eyed needle, transferring stitches from the ribber to the knitter, and then we're going to continue on up. Okay, so I finished reforming the rib, hung my cast-on comb and my claw weights. Now I keep going till I get to the armhole. Okay, as you remember, I wrote the F and B, but I forgot I was writing on the back, and I should have wrote them backwards, but I could still tell. So now I continue working till I get to this line here, because I'm going to do the back first. Okay, so I've got it down, and if you recall, I had cast it on 34 to 34, and I forgot it should have been 32 to 32. But four stitches, two on each side, are not going to make that much of a difference. It'll be a little smidgen larger is all, but most people won't care on that. So now, we're going to do the short row bind off for the armhole shaping. So now I got here to, let's see, 30, 31, 32. So I, on the opposite side, and I went too many, 30, 31. Okay, so it's three stitches, three needles that I bring out. I put my carriage to hold. I knit one row across. And then I want to wrap my yarn under the first needle there. So I go back over here. Now I'm going to do on the left side. Now I'm down to, let's see, 30, 29, 28. This one's a little bit bigger, but it'll work out in the long run. So knit across, wrap the yarn underneath the end needle. Now I'm down to, okay, 25, 26, 27. So now I go over here, 27, and make sure that I have to needle 27. And over is put into hold. Knit across. And 25, 26 and a half. Well, we'll say this is 26. So wrap the yarn under the first needle, knit across. You might want to wrap that needle right at the end there so you don't forget it. So now we go back to the Mylar sheet, 25, 26, knit across. Wrap the yarn under the first needle there. Now I'm to 25. And that's going to be 25 also. Now we're down to 24. Now you could have bound this off each time, but this short rowing does make it a little bit nicer. So 25, 24, 24 and a half, well, we'll make that 24. And 25, 24, 23, well, it's 23 and a half, so I'm just going to do that one needle to make it 23. It's 20, 21, 22, 23. It's the same. Now, I noticed that these needles are starting to pop up. So what I'm going to do is, I guess it's only going to be one. Here in the middle, one of the cast-on combs, and then have the others on that side there. I want to make sure they're not caught, the yarn didn't get caught around the gate pegs. Okay, so I wrap the yarn, 20, 21, 22, 23, it's the same 23, so knit one row. And it's the same 23 again. Just remember to wrap the yarn. Okay, now we're to, that could be 22 because it's actually 22 and a half. Because I didn't wrap that right, something happened. But all I have to do is just bring that yarn underneath is all. Ah, it'll fix itself. Okay, so again, 22. Wrap my yarn first. Oh, that's why, because I'm doing it the opposite way. That's 22 over there. I made a mistake someplace. Back to 22, 20, 21, 22.